Hi everyone. So, it's the first time I've been
here.
So, take a look that I can find myself. Yes, I can see all the comments now. So, welcome everyone for my first live at Elizabeth Craft Designs. Hello. So I see a lot of people coming in. Hello, Els. All right, so it's the first time I'm doing a live at Elizabeth Craft Designs in English. Normally I speak in Dutch, but yeah, let's try this and hopefully I give you some inspiration with these very cute characters and accessories from Josette Dyes. I just think I'm gonna mix these two cards and make that one card off, but we're gonna see how it works. So, I know Anna is here to help me out, and if I say something wrong, please say it, and yeah, correct me if I'm wrong with some things. It's a bit, yeah, I'm a little bit nervous to speak all of this in English, but I think it will be, So, let's start. These are two cards I've showed earlier. And I really like this land of the farmer with the carrots. But also like the flowers and the chicken with the hen in the box. So I will think I will combine these two and with a lot of color. So maybe you've seen my picture, but I've prepared some stuff and I will use distress ink and soft finish cardstock and a lot of dies. So let's make together a card. You'll be fine, we understand. Ah, that's so sweet. I hope I will read all the comments, but if I miss, sorry. Then I will watch it later and give you answers. Yes, I saw a reaction from like, comment and share. You definitely should do this. Just like, comment and share this live. And you can win a $50 gift card. So the winner of Monday is Michelle Smit. So congratulations, you've won the $50 gift card. So congratulations, and if you like, share it and comment, maybe you'll win card. So I've just think I'm starting with the background. For the background I used a base, and the base is like that's this is how I organize all my dies, with tabs and colors. I love colors, so every collection has its own color. So this is the farm collection, this dies I'm gonna use, the florals, and really like the colors. So for the base I used the stitched indented rectangle, a beautiful die to use and who you can build up in different layers, and they are really pretty stitched and at the side. Don't worry, you'll be fine. Thank you. So I see Els is also here. And a lot of people. Now, the base I used is the biggest two dies. Yes, I think I really like that to make a background and put white or black at the back of that card. So, let's take this card. And I really like it to give blue and some brown to make sky and ground. And I will do that. I really love to work with the distress ink. I like to color that. And it's a fun product to use. You can do a lot of things with distress ink. So also color backgrounds. Good morning. Yeah, that's a bit different than here. So here is evening. It's 8 o'clock in the evening. In the evening. So for some guys you it's good morning, and some people good evening. So let's start with the background, and then later this life I will build up all the characters and accessories and a lot of fun stuff. Here in Texas it's 1 p.m. Oh. Yeah, it's... I really like it that I can see... Nah, not meet, but... Yeah, we talked and it's all different than... Than here. So here's 5 May. Yeah. Now, I think this is enough for the background. Because I'm building it up with many layers. So you can see, I think, a small piece of the sky. Yes, it's definitely great how we all can craft from around the world. Absolutely. That's really amazing. So now I'm using tea dye. Tea dye is a beautiful color for ground. It's not that brown, like I've used here for het hek. Ik weet even niet of het Engelse woord niet. Het hek. Or of the ground here. That's better. The ground. I really like light brown. So you can use later at the card a darker brown. So I will try to talk. But it's sometimes hard to find the right words for what I'm doing or what I should say, but I think it will works out. Fence. Ah, fence. Okay. So, the fence. This color is really dark and I really like that dark, but not for the ground. So, I also like to put some ink on the edges. So you cannot see that white where you dye cut it, but yeah, it's something you like or you don't like, I think. And I like it. It still blows my mind how we can talk to each other around the world. Yes. I think it's absolutely great because some of you guys try to learn the Dutch language when you watch to the live from Esther, or I think it's great, and I've learned a lot English watching all these lives, and sometimes I'm some words I know better in English than I know in Dutch, so sometimes I think, what's the Dutch word of this? So that is really, really great. So this is enough for my background. And you can see it's a bit like this. But I really like these two colors. They are soft. And you can do something like a Mermaid Lagoon or... other blues, but this is really softly. So, what should I do next? I have a lot of stuff to do with and what I want to share. And now I have to choose. I think I will some flowers. So, for these flowers, I used the strawberries and the leaves of the farm accessories. So the farm accessories has some leaf. I think it's leaf. That's so this tall with three. Yeah, this. But if you want to build flowers up like here, and you want to build bigger flowers and smaller, you can cut them in two parts, like I've done here. So now maybe you can see it. Now I can have three sizes to build my flowers up. I've tried to learn Dutch from watching Esther, but I'm afraid I'm just too old to pick it up. And maybe you know some words. So happy I made it just a little late. Oh no, you're not late. Yes, I really like to build them up in different sizes. So let's do the small ones. I've just started to color the edges. Maybe you can see that. Here's one sample. So I put some ink on the edges. I wanted a white flower. And then in the middle, I've put in the center, I put some round circle, and that's from also from strawberries. So you have that flower in two sizes with two sizes of center. So you can make their sizes in two. So I thought maybe I should color some stuff. So don't run out of time, but I think we have it's dry. So these are two little pieces, and it's very handy to use this double-sided adhesive, but most of the time I forgot to use it. So I will do it with my blending tool and ink, and then put some glue behind it. And if you forgot it so many times, you will learn to how to use glue with small little parts. First I'm gonna pick some glue. And I just dripped a little bit glue in the center. And I just have a handy tool, and I really like to use that. It's sticky, so you can pick those parts up and you put that down. Then I have my shaping tool. So I just let it dry a little bit. And then I'm gonna shape it a little bit. It's just not that much. So just make circles and put in the center. And I do that with the other one. So I'm just making easy flowers this time. But I think these are really cute. Hi, Anita. I see you're watching too. Thank goodness for the translate underneath. I hope you can understand what I'm saying. I hope, maybe it's a little bit weird how I say something in English, but I think I will make it through. So, then the leaves. I think it's called leaves. But, yeah. You understand what I'm meaning. Let's pick another tool. And peeled paint is definitely a most using color at my projects. Yeah, it's beautiful color. It's not only soft, but yeah, I know. I don't know. It's just beautiful. So, and just here, put some ink at the edges. Ah, thank you, Mariah. So don't forget to share, comment, and like this live to win a gift card. It's not that bad to win a gift card. I think you all know really good stuff to buy from that gift card. I would. So that's just one part of the leaves. Let's say this here. Cleaning my shift. And the next flowers. Look. Oh, I think I used them. Pick one. Oh, it's okay. Now, these are the biggest flowers at strawberries with the leaves. And the centers. And I think I want to color them the same in the center. Or should I do different? Let's put some yellow. So here I also do the edges with antique linen. And only the edges. So this time it will also very handy to use double-sided adhesive. But I forgot it here too. I think I forgot it by all this dice this time. So let's put the centers in the flowers. Aren't these flowers so cute? It's not, the strawberries is a dye that I've bought soon, but I've used them a lot since I have it. Going great, just hanging there. Thank you. Good morning. So let's mold them too at the back. And just a little bit in the front. The daisy is my favorite flower. Ah, yes, that's what I was looking for. The daisy. Yes, I really love that too. But you can color this in any color you want. So if you want to make purple or pink, it's all up to you what you want and how it fits with your project. So now, distress ink is a dye ink, so it is transparent. And if you use two colors, it will work out very beautiful. So I will do that. So let's start with peeled paint. Just one layer. So I will do that with every lief. So not all the leaves are the same. Because flowers aren't the same in the garden or anywhere. And then I choose Mood Lawn. And then I will show you the difference between this one and the other one. And it's just how much ink you put on it. So you can play with the colors with two or three types of green, purple, blue, what you want. So now you can see it's not only Mood Lawn, but a little bit of peeled paint. So then you can build from light to dark. And with the last one, the bigger ones, I will do first Mood Lawn. So the first layer is with Mood Lawn. Oh, you are so sweet that it helped me through it. So I was talking to Els, so I'm just so nervous to do a live in English. But yeah, I think I have to do this. So once I do something, it's okay. So now I'm a little bit relaxer than before. So now the first layer is Mood Lawn, and the second layer I will do a peeled paint. And now you see difference between this one, but also this one. The peeled paint is the bovenste, hoe zeg je het in het Engels? I don't know, bovenste. Someone? Hey, Gerry! Wat leuk dat... How fun you are here! I just want to talk in Netherlands. Sorry. Thank you all so much. I will try. I'm gonna do my best. And I have a lot of fun of making these cards and share that with you. So, hopefully you can see the difference. Maybe I'll put it closer to the camera. With my green fingers. Look, yes, you see more Mood Lawn than peel paint. And here you see more peel paint than Mood Lawn. And if I put this there, this only peel paint. So I really try to make different combines. Up a layer. Thank you, Jacqueline. Yes, that's the word I'm searching for. So, that are the flowers. And I'm not... Oh, no, also. Almost. I need to make these flowers, too. And I will do that with... I didn't pick a color for this one. Oh, yeah, I know. Yellow I chose. So this is a flower from the Florals 8. But I would say this flower is this dye. And this dye is in more than only Florals 8. But for now I use Florals 8. But I think it was in more flower sets than only this one. This coming Sunday is Mother's Day in the US. I was able to celebrate early and my children got me a Canon selfie printer. Oh, that's a great gift. Yeah, I understand why you're excited. It's really great to use that, absolutely. So so. Just do the edges of this flower too. So Sunday is also Mother's Day here in the Netherlands. I'm not a mom, but I have a mom. So I'll give her some flowers, but she got it already. And that are real flowers, not this one, but real. So let's make the center of these flowers, I think with brown, would be beautiful. So it was very handy to put double-sided adhesive again. But it's okay for now. So many possibilities. Yes, there are absolutely really possibilities. And I really like to combine dyes from different collections, but also from different designers. They are really great to use together. So you can use these characters from Josette or the flowers from Anita in the planners of cards or what you want, or scrapbooking page. And I see a lot of different styles in the group, and that's also great. So this flower. And then we have to make some animals. And that's also a lot of fun to make them. This looks like sunflowers now. I didn't have that idea, but now when I'm making it, I see it's a sunflower. But a little bit smaller than the flowers, the sunflowers in the accessory from the farm. So let's dry this a bit and bring them in shape. It's not that much, but I think I like it to do that a little bit. And these are really small flowers, so you can build them, mold them. Bigger flowers are easier to mold. You can see that more than with these little flowers. So let's put that a little bit aside. I think for my feeling I have a lot of mess around here, but I think it is okay. So let's make the sheep. My friend the sheep. This is a really cute one. So from some parts I did some antique linen at the edges. Now I have to build them up and color them a little bit. And I see I didn't pick a color for that, but that's okay. I have it here. So you can make it what you want, or how they look, or colors what you want. But I like it this way. But sometimes I choose other colors than other time. So it's fine. You can do everything you want. If I miss comments, sorry, I'm packing for my lunch for work. Okay. I think I've missed a lot of comments, but yeah, it will be okay, I think. So let's see. The sheep, I think you all know that, is from the farm collection from Josette. It's a really cute one. Because, yeah, it's adorable. So color these parts, and the sheep is a little bit easy, I think, because there are not so many colors. The hen and the hen from the hen and rooster is more colorful than the sheep. Ah, you're making the sheep, is it this? Yes, I'm making the sheep. Absolutely. So, I see you're doing a lot of characters too, Ilse. I didn't know you do that. I thought you were making more pages than just little parts and characters. But it's fun to see it with you. I've made it this week too. Yeah, I love that show on the sheep. Absolutely. Maybe some... You definitely should watch the post from Ilse. She made the show on the sheep. And it's a really cute one. I would make that too for my cousins. I think I should work a little bit harder. Otherwise I'm not... I'm a little bit late, I think. So now the eyes. This stay white. And I only have the two centers. With black. Yeah, the sheep is so cute. But I love all the animals. So... Yeah. If someone needs advice what for animal you need to buy, then I think I can give you enough advice. I think you should definitely buy them all. So I just make the eyes a little bit black. A little bit. My son adores it too. So let's glue the eyes. And these dyes are perfect because when you dye, cut them out, you can see the shapes of the eyes and the mouth and nose. So it's very handy to see where you can put everything. Let's put the center of the eyes. And when I'm preparing this life, I thought, maybe it's the sheep too much to put them at the card. But yeah, let's make it and see if I can make it to the card. Or he will be at another card another time. So let's put the ears. I have just toothpink. Let's put some cards. I have to pick something. Yes. So the ears are going at the back. But you can make them different. So put them on a lower or higher. So this time I will... I think it's the wrong side. So, I'm just a little bit nervous. So. Where's the other side of the tool? Yeah, it's... I don't know. I really don't know, I think. I only lose that sticky part. It looks a little bit weird now when I'm doing this. I don't know why, but it is. I think it will work out when I do this. Yes. I don't know how I say that in English, but it looks like een kaal hoofd. Een kaal hoofd, geen idee wat dat is in het Engels. I don't know. But it's really funny, I think. Where did you get these dyes? From Elizabeth Craft Design. So, Anna sent a lot of links in the chat also, I see, from the products. So you can take a look at that, or rewatch it, and then you will see the comments from her too. A bald head, yes, that it is. It looks really funny. Yeah, I thought, oh, I do something wrong, but no, I didn't. Oh, isn't this cute? Every time when I'm making this, I'm really, yeah, in love with all these animals. They are so cute. So, I have to do this part, and I'm doing that in black. So I could do that when I did the other black. But it's, I really like to color this part. Sometimes I'll be sitting here and just color and build animals. Not the whole card, but only make flowers or animals or, and I will use that later, but not at that moment. So just watching Netflix and color these animals and build them up and use them later. If you don't have inspiration, just go make animals or characters or accessories and then use it later. I think you always find a way to use the dyes. This time I used the sheep, but yeah, all the animals are so cute. The donkey, I really love the donkey too. But I can't put all the characters this time at one card. Maybe another time. I will try. I did a card with four animals. That's really well. This is a farm bundle, it's great. Yeah, I think there's a farm bundle, I'm not sure, but I think it is. That you can buy all the dyes at once. Maybe, but please, Anna, if I say it wrong, then please say it. I know there is an bundle from the newest art journal special collection. So it's just really relaxing to build them up. I think my head is a bit weird glued. Let's put them off and glue them again. I have to put them higher on this side. So that's better. Oh, Simona, I didn't know where this site is from. So I gave an answer, but I didn't know the answer. I don't know where the other site for is. I will search to it and find out where they are for. And I will give you an answer later. And now he looks very real. Oh, didn't did the right one. That one. Put this one at the back. The color for the face is, I think, tattered rosé. I thought I will do it very quickly, but it's not so quickly, I think. Yes, I think I will build them up. Let me see. So to build them up, I use some layers, which I've hidden somewhere. Up there. To build it up, I have dyed some grass from the adventure edges, and also used the other adventure edges to make the ground from the farmer. To put that a carrots behind. So I think I will do the grass in front, and I sized this paper exactly like this die is, so you can cut the die from the grass exactly how this is. So let's color them also. I think it's a lot of coloring I do. I hope it's not boring to see that. So now I'm thinking, oh, I'm using a lot of coloring. So just let's use vintage photo. And also this ground you can build up with two colors. So now I'm using only vintage photo, but you can put that ground espresso next to. And you get a really beautiful brown color. Tattered rosé. I used from the face. So I'm not coloring the whole part because I built them up with layers. So here you can see this part I dyed too, but I've lay it different. So I think I'm not using all the animals I'm prepared. Because that will be a lot of animals. Too much, I think. I think two is enough from this. So I will show you soon how it all worked together. But for now I'm have to color the grass. And I'm just making two layers so you can build that up too. So this looks very green, huh? If you see the leaves there, This is very, very green. But maybe I will do some pink paint at it. But I think, yes, I really like it to use that also in different colors. I really like colors. Colors, colors, colors. So I'm not doing the whole sides, but it's a no-end mold. The adventure items are no-ending, so you can make them as long as you want. It only dies the top, and then you can make it so as long as you want it. So that's very easy. I cut them here a little bit smaller. Just net. It's just how your card is. I'm just doing some peeled paint. I think that's better. Just a little bit. I'm doing the edges. And the other one. And also between different layers, there's also some different colors, but that's okay. Grass is not the same color on every spot. So I think it's, I like it to make, that's really high, but I think to make the ground here, and put some grass at the front, and then the sheep and the here. Let's try it. So if you want to put some carrots like I did here behind the ground, you can tape them like a pocket. I hope I say it good. So I put some tape at three sides. Yes. So there and here. I also do it with this one, this one, this one. So this is very easy tape to use. I use this tape a lot, not this for little parts. I didn't use that, but this tape I use a lot. And I think I will put that this now, so I can see how big it is. Oh, it's okay to draw later. You can rewatch, definitely. So let's stick them here. Now it's only this side, so when I have carrots, I can put them between these layers, so it's in the ground. So when I'm doing this here, let's glue the carrots from the farm accessories together. Just a little bit glue. So the carrots are colored also with distress ink. But you can color them with any color you want. So this is spiced marmalade and peeled paint, I think. I think I'm putting three carrots in there. So this I will use later at another card. So you can glue this. You can also put this in here. So if you want, I have cousins, so they can put it, yeah, pick it up. Haal het eruit. So I think it's fun to do that here. So I say in the beginning, the sky is not so high as it is. But I think it's good for this time. Then I have the layers of grass. Let's look if this would work here. Yeah, that will work. So I also put the grass as a little pocket. So tape them on three sides. So I can put the flowers behind some layers. I love mocha. They are like a little puzzle. Yes. It sometimes is a little puzzle, absolutely. I think that this will be enough to do here. And then I will take my scissors. And I think I will have to keep it, cut it shorter or color it more green. But with the fans, and that's how I did it the other time. I lay the fans exactly on the bottom of this line, so you don't see that line. Is that tape? Yeah, that's 1/8. I don't know how that is in English, but 1/8, yes. I don't think this grass has to be that long. I think this is enough. Yeah, so the fence is also exactly how this card is. But I will use their ground espresso. But yeah, I use this size because it's really small, so you can put a lot of things behind it. But if you don't have that much, for example, you use 3 flowers, you can use the bigger one. But that's just how much you will put it between that layers. But sometimes I don't know if I will put there something between the layers or I don't. So I will always tape them on 3 sides. And I can always put there something between or not. But that's fine. You don't see that if you did it or not. So I think my ink is a little bit empty. But I will fill that after the live. Let's put some vintage photo there. So the fence will have a little bit more color. Sometimes I forgot to fill the distress inks. And then when I'm working with it, I think, oh yeah, I should definitely do that when I'm done. Because I'm using it now. But yeah, I forgot it. So I should definitely do that after this live. So I can use it tomorrow. I will do my best to do that. What's 3 millimeter in American? Yeah, I don't know how. Yeah, I can't say that in English. I think that's my, I don't know. I should definitely search that word after this live. So I can tell you maybe another time when I'm maybe here. So it's almost 8 o'clock, or 9 o'clock, I think. I'm talking a lot. But I hope it's okay if I'm doing a little bit longer. Or I should stop and make it done after this live. But I don't know what else want. So I think that I should gewoon just glue it. So let's make it a little bit greener. So you don't see the white that much. Now only put the glue on this line, really small. So if you're doing that, you can put the fence exactly on this line, like this. So now you don't see that layer because it's hidden between the fence. So I should tape that too. Oh, you can finish. Yeah, I thought it was very hard to talk a whole hour in English, but I think it worked for now. Maybe some words I have to search how to say that, but so put some tape at three sides. And believe it or not, but my English wasn't that good. At school, it was a really problem to talk English or to read. I can read English or listen English a little bit. But talking, it was really awful. Oh, that was, I didn't like that. So I did always my best to make it well, but yeah. So this looks so cute, huh? I really like that. So let's see where I have to put this. If I could the sheep in front, I think this was good enough. So it's okay that the sheep is so tomorrow, my two cousins are sleeping over here, so it's vacation for them. And Friday they will be here the whole day. And they are really like crafting too when I'm doing it. So they sit here and they really like these characters too. I think I will post that here if I don't forget it. So I think that's okay. This is okay. Yes. So these carrots felt. Let's put them here. So now the flowers. I wish I spoke another language as well as you. Oh, thank you so much. You should hear my Dutch. Yes, but Dutch is a really difficult language to learn because it's really hard sometimes, I think. So I will glue these flowers. Just let my glue open. So just what I'm saying at the beginning, I cut this leaf in three sizes. So use this one. So you have three sizes to make flowers. If you want smaller or bigger, you can make it. If you can cut it in sizes. So I'm just thinking to make this a little bit smaller. With a little daisy. Next time you will talk Norwegian. No, no, I don't think I'm speaking that. No, this, I will learn English better than I'm doing now. So Norway, I will, I don't think I will can do that. So then this sunflowers. They are really, maybe I've put some of this. Yeah, that's better. Just a little bit, but it's just better than the whole. So let's see how I put these flowers through. So here I make a whole line. But I think I will do it different this time. Because I like to do it different every time I'm making cards. So let's do these sides. I see white, so I don't want to see white. Just put them in there. So you can glue it down. Or you can just glide it between the layers. But I think I will glue it down a little bit. Just cut a piece off. So I can put them easier in this layer. Do that with this one too, I think. So they don't have to be that long. You should fight somebody from Norway as a guest. Let's see if you understand Norwegian. Yes, we should definitely do that. As we try in Dutch and English, then we can learn Norway too. I think I put them between the wrong layer, but okay. Okay, let's see. I can glue them between the fence, but I don't like that. Maybe I will do some daisies here. I just forgot to put the sunflowers. I want them to the other grass layer, but okay. I will find a way. I really want to cover this leaf, but maybe I can put this one there because it's small. I'm just not have to think about that too long because it will be harder and harder to put glue on it. I'm from Norway and easily addicted. Now else, there's someone who is Norway and easily addicted. So, because I didn't glue the carrots down, I can put them where I want. So maybe I will do it like this. So I have more space to glue the flowers down. So maybe just one here. Yes. That it is. Sometimes you have that moment that you think, yes, that is what I want. Now I have that moment now. And this sheep. Oh, isn't this cute? Oh, I'm so happy of this. So this little sheep is here. Now let's see. I think that's enough of flowers and sheep and that. I would my idea was to use the hen and rooster with the box, like I did here, but that will be another time. I think this is really cute too. Maybe I will do some stamp from the farm collection. Let's see. I just, every time when I pick these stamps, I really want to choose another sentence. But I think I will do... Yeah, what should I do? I will think over that later, because I have to dye a label. I don't have that here, I think. Maybe I have. But I think this is really big. But I can cut that. Yeah, I will do that now. I'm just over time, so I can do this stamp also. Just choose now. Akis. I'm saying that to myself. Just choose now. And then I have to choose, because I can really do really long time about choosing which die or which stamp I will use. And that's really, really weird. Simple life. Hey there. Okay. That will be hey there. So let's do hey there with black ink. Yeah, the carrots make, because it's orange, they will give also a lot of more color. It's not only yellow, white, green, brown, white. But it's also, yeah, I think. So I don't think it's, maybe I should cut this off. I think this is a dye from the Planner Essentials, I think. There are many labels on that set. I guess I was that dye. So you can see that you can use all the way dyes together. Let's make the edges a little bit orange, and then it's done. Almost. Yeah. Just to bring that beautiful orange color back at the bottom. So it's not much, but I think it's also real cute. Let's glue this and don't let it fall out of the hands. So, I think that's really nice. So, I will glue this later behind it. But, this will be the card. And I really liked it. Echt. Really. Echt. Really. Just stay in English. Yeah, I think this is it for tonight. So, I had a lot of fun. It's a little bit later than 1 hour. But... I will learn it to do it quicklier. But I think I liked it. These layers and also. So don't forget to like, comment, and like, comment, and share to win a $50 gift card. Yeah, it was really nice. And maybe I will come back another time. Or you can see my cards in the group. Thank you all for watching. It was really nice to do. Have a great day or evening. And yeah. Thank you so much. Bye.